How are you doing, beautiful souls? It is your sister at heart. My name is Princess Yanja, and I am here again with another video. Today's video, we are going to talk about no contact parents. There are people who haven't been in contact with their parents because their parents don't know how to communicate with them, and they chose their boundaries because they decided that they want to change the cycle or the toxic patterns. So without wasting any more of your time, let's just go straight to today's video. You know, when you have dealt with narcissistic parents, you know exactly what is going to be spoken about in this video. Most of the time when you become an adult and you are dealing with narcissists as parents, you are much likely to go in no contact with your parents. And that is because your parents don't know how to communicate with you, as you don't know how to communicate with them. These are the parents that might have told you back in the days when you were trying to be, you know, trying to bond with them, or trying to be light with them, or trying to, you know, joke around and build a relationship with them. They'll tell you things like, you are too forward, we are papa. I think most of us have been told those words as as kids, you know, go to your papa. And that's the true version of you that is being suppressed every time when the very same person, Omzalwako, tells you that you shouldn't be yourself, that you feel to be, that is harmless to other people. You know, and things like when your parents tell you things, Zoguti, I'm not your friend, you know, don't act like we're friends, you know, don't do this, don't do that, and they act like this authority on your life, instead of also living a room. Zoguti, as much as you need to have authority as my parent, you also have to remember, Zoguti, I'm a human being, and I adore you as my parent, and I'm your child, so I expect us to have some sort of a bond. I'm hoping that we're going to show some love, we're going to have ways where we can communicate and show love to one another. So what normally happens to such parents is that the children are going to grow up and they're not going to know how to communicate with them. They're not going to know how to create a relationship with them, because now they were taught, we are not friends. You know, you can't come like that to me. Don't behave like that to me. So if you are depriving somebody to behave like the persons that they are, harmlessly so, respectfully so, and you told them that they shouldn't come in that way to you, then it becomes hard over the years to now change all of a sudden and be somebody who's going to be friendly to your parents, open and talk to them about everything, because they taught you themselves from a young age that you shouldn't come to them in that manner. So most of the time, parents who have children who tend to have no contact when they grow up with them are children who saw their parents, they saw their pain, they saw their traumatic experiences, because now they're adults themselves. So they know how hard it is to be an adult. They know how hard it is now to raise a child. But as much as that is true, because now they know what they know, they still know, Uguti, there is some sort of lightness that they need to have so that their children can have a relationship with them. They are trying to do things differently than they were done to them. When my parents out there who raised this type of kids who are now adults in a way that was gaslighting them. They cared less about how their day was for them. They didn't care how their schooling experience is going. The only thing they knew is that if I pay your bills and I give you food and I clothe you and I take you to school, I've done what I need to do as a parent. Not knowing what to load, this is a person that you are dealing with. This is somebody with needs, psychological needs, emotional needs. Gaslighting comes in a point where a parent will start blaming the child who is now an adult for the lack of relationship between a parent and a child. And not seeing it, Uguti, this child is now in a place where they have learned to create healthy boundaries for themselves and allow people in their spaces who accommodate them for who they are, who love them for who they are, who do not have expectations of what kind of people they're supposed to be or how they're supposed to show their love. People who see their parents for what they truly are normally people who have gone through a healing of some sort themselves. These are the people who need to then go back to their own childhood, look into the things they might have went through that might have also included their parents doing or lack of where they needed to. And so now when they see what things unfolded to be, they now are aware, Uguti, I shouldn't repeat the same things that were done to me, because now I know how it feels to have a parent who behaves in such a manner. So that's where you need to now change the things around and do better for your own children. Now that's what we call breaking generational cycles or breaking toxic patterns in our bloodline. It's not about faulting our parents as bad people, but it's being able to look into their life experiences and see where they would have fixed but decided not to fix, and see their fears that also caused them to live the life that they ended up living, or to have a relationship with us as adult children that we ended up having. We need to see things for what they truly are. And for you to see, Noma, in seeing, you would know, yes, they did try their best. Yes, now I'm an adult myself. I can see the things that are happening. Life is expensive. It is stressful to be an adult in this day and age, you know, and you are constantly trying your best to be the one who gives your children the best life possible. But sometimes even giving them the best life, also there needs to be a limit, because when you overgive them, sometimes also they become entitled and they grow up into being these individuals who are self-centered, who are narcissistic. So there's always going to be a line to draw when it comes to any form of relationship, including our own parents and our children, because this is a cycle that will repeat itself through us when our children now have to look into their own childhood for the sake of healing their own traumas, so that they can become better versions of themselves. They will have to look into the things that we might have contributed also, Nati, in their lives that they're now trying, they're struggling so much for. Because the first step in solving a situation is the ability to identify the problem. Once you identify the problem, you know now what measures you need to put together to find a solution of that particular problem. So this is a cycle, an endless cycle. But yes, there are people who are adults today who have parents that they have no contact with, not because they hate them as such, but because they're trying to protect their peace and they're trying to make sure it ended with them, so that the children or the grandchildren of their parents don't get exposed into some of the toxic behavior that they are unwilling to change. Because that's the frustrating thing about being raised by parents who might have gone through their own traumatic experiences, is that, okay, fine, I'm aware that you went through pain. I know, Wuti, now this is what you went through, and this is the reason why you raised me the way you did, or you behave the way you do, but I don't see change. There's no change. They proceed into the wrongdoings. They want to make excuses for their behavior. They say things such as, I compromised a lot of things in my life to make sure, Wuti, when you had a roof above your head. Of course you needed to do that. That's your job. It's your job, mommy and daddy. You were supposed to provide protection for the offsprings that you brought, you decided to joyfully bring into this world. It's not something that now they need to go and tell the children that I fed you, I dressed you, I provided a home for you. You're supposed to do. Those are the basic stuff that you need to do, you know, as a parent. So when it comes to a no contact also, it becomes a bit sad to people who are the outsiders who might not know the inside full story. We are dealing with a narcissist here, and we love this narcissist. So for peace sake, distance is what is going to be the solution. We're going to love this person from a distance. We're going to make sure, Wuti, if there is a possibility for us to contribute in their well-being, we're going to make sure, Wuti, we contribute in their well-being where they are. Because breaking generational curses is not for the weak. You cannot keep on doing the same things that have been pulling the family backward and call yourself a generational curse cutter. For you, you gotta be different. There gotta be some measures that you're willing to put in. You gotta be willing to be hated. You gotta be willing to be seen like the crazy one in the family, because everyone is comfortable with the things that are falling apart or things that are contributing in this family falling apart. So as somebody who have seen what is happening and you are unable to turn a blind eye on it, it's better that you distance yourself to make better decisions for your children and make sure, Wuti, you don't repeat the same thing that was repeated with you. Because people tend to do what was done to them, and our parents, chances are, they went through worse. And also, I just want to say this to the children who are now the adults of the parents who are not willing to change, parents who are gaslighters, parents who play a victim and who minimize your pain in the experience because they just can't see outside of themselves. Ayoguti, we don't have to really necessarily hate them, because when you hate them, you're prolonging the curse. When you hate them, you're not learning from the situation. You need to see them for what they are, accept them for what they are, love them for what they are, and then decide, Uguti, as much as that is going to be I'm going to also draw healthy boundaries where I will make sure ukuthi as much as I love them and as much as I care for them, they cannot have a say or any contribution in my life or the children or my children's life, because we saw how that unfolded with me and my siblings. You know, you gotta be able to see that, and you gotta be able, you need to allow yourself to really forgive them, like genuinely forgive them. Not because mhlambe you are pressured to forgive them, not because you are no longer angry. You can be angry and still choose to forgive them, because these people shown you or given you an experience as a child from them as their parent or as your parent that they also knew. They produced what they knew. But when you know better, that's why now also you are doing things differently, because you are also doing based on what you know. So in the equation, really, as long as there's improvement, as long as the past mistakes are not repeated, we are all winning in the process, including them. They might not see it now, but your kids are their grandchildren. So when they become better versions of you and them, they are also winning, because this is their bloodline too. And that is the end of our today's video. I hope that it did find you in a good spirit. If you are coming for the first time, again, don't forget to subscribe. Please do share also as well for more people to see ukuthi how do we heal as indlu emnyama and be better versions of ourselves. Love and light. Till next time.